So many lives are being blessed because of those of you that are sharing with the New Life Evangelistic Center. You're touching the lives of the hurting and homeless in so many ways. Be sure you stay tuned. I'm Larry Rice, and this is Here's Help. Whether it's in Potosi, Missouri, whether it's in St. Louis out on the streets, whether it's in Springfield, Joplin, Van Buren, a host of other locations, let's not forget Columbia. You're helping so many people in need, and the training programs in New Bloomfield, Marshfield, and the rest. Tell us your name.
My name is Joan A. Sisko.
Hi, Joan. You're down here at the New Life Evangelistic Center, Day Center here in Springfield, Missouri. And how do you like this place?
I like it. They serve good food here.
Do they really? God bless
you. Yeah,
they do. You're meeting some good friends, are you?
Oh, yeah. I met me a new friend right there.
Did you really?
Yeah, after my husband abused me and put me out on the street.
Wow.
My ex-husband, July 16, 2014.
And you found yourself on the street. So to help people understand, how traumatic is it for a woman like that when she encounters
it's
that?
It's rough.
Is this yours?
Yes, it is.
And so you have to get around using this?
Yes. Because he abused me pretty bad.
Wow. And so you ended up out on the streets.
Yes.
I mean, it happens. It can happen to a woman at any time, can't it?
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
It could happen to anybody. He got put out on the street, too, by his ex-wife.
Wow. So you can come here. You can meet new friends. You can fellowship with people. You're not just left sitting somewhere where the police tell you got to move. You got to keep going.
And Menahem's going to have babies pretty soon.
Oh, wow.
Four of them.
Oh, that's an awful lot. Hopefully not all at one time.
Yes.
Oh, is that what the doctors tell you?
Yes.
Well, that'll be something.
They did.
Well, that's quite a thing, I'm telling you.
It's a miracle I'm having babies.
Wow, it's a miracle.
Yes, a big blessing.
God is a miracle working God, isn't he?
He is. Yeah, he is. He put me with him.
Oh, God.
It's his babies.
Wow, God is a
great God. He's the daddy.
And tell us, is that right? And tell us your name.
I'm Sheldon. My name's Sheldon Carr.
Wow. Y'all are going to start a new family, are you?
Yes.
Yeah, I just hope we'll be off the streets before they come, because I don't want nobody taking the babies away, you know?
Yeah. So there's that many babies?
Oh. I mean, we probably got a friend that might put us up for a little bit, but I don't know how long for sure.
Just having to trust God, starting a new family?
Yeah, I got a job waiting on me, just getting a place.
Tell people, how hard is it to get a place?
It's pretty hard.
Is it really? What do you need to get a place?
You only need more than $750, I guarantee you that.
Yes.
And with me not working, that makes it twice as hard.
How important is this place to you?
Oh, it's very important, because on rainy days, like, even though we wasn't here yesterday because we had to do laundry.
Yeah.
But, yeah, because like she said, you know, we do have good food here. And there are certain mornings I need coffee, and I get here early enough, I'm going to get my cup of coffee.
There's people here letting you know that God loves you.
Yes.
Helping you discover family values.
Exactly,
the love of Christ.
Yeah.
Well, this is what the Lord has told us to do, to let our light so shine before men and women, they may see our good works and glorify our Father who's in heaven. And we're desiring to let Christ's light and love flow through us right now. He's a miracle-working God. There's hurting people out on the streets. Please understand them, and please share with New Life at this time, as we desire to be there when people are hurting. So many people, and it's to New Life Evangelistic Center, they continue to turn.
Tell us your name.
Jeff West.
And Jeff, so what do you know today? What's going on?
Well, nothing much. Just praying to God that I can get me a place by this weekend.
Mm-hmm.
And I've been praying and praying to keep this open for the veterans, the regular people, help them get their front door, and I do everything what I can, but I'm just praying to God I can get me a place.
Mm-hmm.
That's all I'm doing.
So you've been looking for housing here locally, and is it that housing is out of your price range?
Yes, it is. Price range is too high.
So you're needing like a place where you're able to have more access, right? So it would be
ramp for the front door, maybe go up and down, and I just keep praying until I get it through. I hope it does.
Okay. Well, we'll be praying for you too. What sort of, are you going through one door to try to access housing, or
they're too high? I can't afford it. I only get two checks, and I can't afford it. All the other, I make $600 a month, and enough to pay rent.
In the meantime, where have you been staying?
Right now, in the long run, my sister-in-law put me in a motel, and I paid yesterday my first week rent. Last week, I paid last week. My money's gone. I stayed there for almost 2 weeks, and Saturday's my deadline. If I ain't got the money, I gotta be on the streets.
Yeah.
I lived on the streets for 2 weeks before I got the motel. I don't like it. I know what these people are going through. They used to have a roof over their head, like me. And I just pray for all the people around here.
Okay. Well, let's pray together now, okay? Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, you see our brother's need, and you see his need for housing. We know that you're a God that answers prayer. And Lord, you have an apartment in mind for him. We pray that you would just connect him, Lord, with the apartment that he needs. We pray that you open the right doors so that he's not using up all his money in hotels, Lord, but that he could have stable and permanent housing. We know that you can do this, and we ask, Father, in the name of Jesus, that you would provide for him, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. And we're believing, God, that you have what you ask in faith. You know, that's what Jesus told us, is that we have what we ask of him. We ask in faith, and God is a good God. He wants you to be in a good place, good environment. Amen. And I know that you've been faithful. You volunteer here a lot, don't you?
Yes, sir. I volunteer too much.
Everybody. Well, God sees that. He sees your heart, that you're volunteering, that you're doing all that you can to help out, and so he's got something greater in mind for you as well.
Thank you. Amen.
Well, it's a delight having you here, and we thank you for your help here. I want to encourage all of you who are watching at home to please give to the work of New Life Evangelistic Center. We're so grateful for the volunteers that we have here, people that are actually in need themselves, but who by giving back, are able to receive. And we just ask that you would keep this brother in prayer, and also that you would give of yourselves to this work here, because that's how we operate, is because of the love of God, the grace of God, and of people sharing what they have with those in need. So please give a gift to New Life Evangelistic Center, and you can reach us online, newlifeevangelisticcenter.org. Thank you very much.
Thank you. You're welcome.
Hi, Brad. How you been doing?
All right.
How's this place been a help to you?
It's a place to get something to eat, and it's a place to get out of the cold during the day.
Is it really?
Yeah. And get clothes if you don't have anything to wear.
So it's been a big help to you. I see they've made a really nice meal today, haven't they?
Yeah, pretty good.
Well, that's a blessing. We thank God for those volunteers coming in with these items, don't we?
Yeah. Yeah, it's always the people that bring lunch here that from the community help out a bunch for people like me and everybody in here.
We thank God for the love that they show.
Yeah, right.
Just day by day.
Yeah, one day at a time.
What a blessing they are.
Yeah.
Hi, I'm Rebecca Lee. I've been coming here about a year and a half or so, about once a month, sometimes twice a month, to serve, and I love it. I feel like we're a bright light in some of their lives. It makes us feel good, so I have to admit that it's totally selfish, too, that we walk away and we just feel great for the day doing it. So it's good. It's a good thing.
Rebecca, mm-hmm. You look like you gathered up a lot of friends and family members, too.
I do. I probably have about 40 people total, mm-hmm. and it's kind of, they can't always make it every month, but we always have a full crowd. We always have enough.
Well, tell us, so how do you put this together? You go out and gather food from a wide variety of people?
Right.
What do you do?
Well, I actually make my own sign-up sheet, mm-hmm. And kind of plan a little menu, and then I send an email out to all of the people that volunteer with us, and the ones that are available that week, they sign up. We get some of the food donated. Like, we've become very good at putting ourselves out there and saying, hey, you have any leftover food? And so if people have a lot of leftover food, we'll take it, and we can turn anything into a meal. So, but a lot of us, you know, buy the food too, but we
It really looks
get
like
some of
the
it.
People are really enjoying it. Uh-huh. And we have an awful lot of people that are coming to us here in Springfield, don't we?
We really do. It's really a lot of people here, a lot.
It looks like the numbers just keep growing and
they
growing.
They do. We see new faces every time we're here.
Right. I mean, there's days we have close to 250 people.
Right.
Just because this is the largest daytime walk-in facility in southwestern Missouri, northwestern Arkansas, particularly Springfield, that the New Life Evangelistic Center has.
Right. That's right. And everybody in town knows this is a place to get a good meal and come for prayer or whatever you need.
Well,
you can find it here.
They also get their laundry here. They have computers they look for jobs at. They got a free store that's here. They got lockers where they store their other stuff. They even got a place they take naps if they've had a hard night.
That's right. There's a lot of cushy places to sleep over there, yeah. And take a shower.
And we really thank God. Maybe you're not able to volunteer, but you certainly can share that much-needed tax-deductible gift. This is one of a growing numbers of outreaches of the New Life Evangelistic Center, directly in the lives of the hurting and homeless. And you can share that much-needed gift with New Life Evangelistic Center at P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri. That's 63166. We have training programs all over. One of the places they have a training program that's reaching out among a lot of homeless people is in New Bloomfield, Missouri. Let's take a look at that.
Welcome to New Life Evangelistic Center in New Bloomfield, Missouri. Here you see some of our guys walking down the driveway toward my car. They tend to work together in groups of people. Here they're unloading food for the animals from my vehicle. One of the principals at NLEC in New Bloomfield, and really at a lot of our locations, is many hands make light work, and so the guys learn to work together. That's a life skill, and it's one that that can't be taken for granted. Sometimes we're tempted to say, well, you know, I can do things a lot faster alone and not want to involve others, but in community, which is what this is, where the guys work together and they live together. They learned that many hands make light work, and that they have a lot to learn about living together, getting along, and looking out for one another, caring for each other. Here you see the guys working in a greenhouse, preparing the soil, and now we have our cattle. This is a building herd of Charolais cattle, and here's an example of Black Angus and other cows. The cattle work here is probably the largest work that we do. We have nearly everyone involved in cattle. There are about 14 people who work together on the property, and most of them work with the cattle. These Charolais, we had five cows, and each of them had a baby. So it was quite astounding to see all of them have babies. It's really a beautiful thing. Here you see one of them nursing. So this is the area behind the care center, or the energy. This is what we call the energy building. And in this scene, the guys are working on a tiller, and the other guys are bringing the veggie oil out of the building. The guys here learn to do a lot of things themselves that would normally be, kind of farmed out for someone else to do, including fixing tillers. This is one of the dome houses that demonstrates wood burning and how to set up a wood burning system. This is a demonstration dome, and its purpose is to show how to build with cordwood. And this is an earth contact home with a beautiful bridge leading up to it. I like to think of these as almost like hobbit homes, not quite. But the guys here are cleaning up and getting rid of unwanted creatures and bugs in preparation for energy fares, free energy fares. Now this house in the distance here is actually the dorm. New Life provides housing, and this other house is called the Radio House. This is where Carl and Matthew, who work in radio, live. But New Life provides housing to everyone who works here full time. We provide room and board. Here you see Carl in the radio room. This is where he makes spots and gets things ready to go on the air. And this is Matthew. He is the engineer who's actually putting things over the air. The guys are getting ready now to go in for Bible study. You'll notice that they tend to all walk together and do things together on a regular basis. This is actually the inside of the care center. We have a lot of demonstration boards set up, and this is where the guys all sit whenever we have Bible study and read aloud from the scriptures together.
Tell us your name.
My name's David Adam.
Hey, David, what do you think of this place here?
It's a good place, yeah. I'm a veteran myself, so I've had a lot of help come through here, and I've also volunteered.
So you're a veteran. When were you in the armed services?
1980. It wasn't really a war, but I still...
You were in the service. You know, it's hard for people to believe there are veterans that are without homes right now in there.
Yes, sir.
A lot of them out there.
Yes, and we have a program here, Home at Last, that helps homeless veterans.
Right here at our Veterans Coming Home Center, at the New Life Evangelistic Center.
Yes.
How is it helping veterans?
It's getting them off the street, and hopefully they'll pursue a job afterwards.
Mm-hmm.
And
so this program we have here, the New Life Evangelistic Center in Springfield, is really helping a lot of veterans.
Yes. They encourage them to, you know, do better for themselves. They just need a helping hand sometimes, yeah.
You mentioned that the Home at Last program's really helped. How did it help you?
They gave me, like, counseling, budget counseling, found me an apartment. Then I had a job, and they paid my first 5 months of rent. And then, you know, I was able to stand on my feet, you know, through working and, you know, maintain my apartment that way.
So you got all that through coming to this particular place here, the Veterans Coming Home Center at the New Life Evangelistic Center has in Springfield, and it's helped break the cycle of homelessness for you. Is that right?
Yes, sir. This is where it all started. Filled out the paperwork, and yeah, that's my story. Yeah. And I try to give back because of that.
My name is Jerome. I'm president of the two-year program in the Larry Rice Ministry out here in Springfield. I'm enjoying my time and helping the Lord out here in Springfield. I appreciate Larry Rice helping me get on spiritually and letting me assist the poor people.
I'm Shirley Wolf. It's been very hard for me out there. I've not been able to find food at times, but the VA has helped me. The Cook's Kettle's helped me, places like that. The Veterans Home Center has given me blankets and clothes, and they've fed me. And around the holidays, it's worse because I'm not around my family, and it breaks me apart. I at least have some of my friends there that are going to help me through it. Spring's here too, and I love the weather, but I don't like being without family.
Well, here's some of the guys that have been helping out here, feeding the homeless. How does it feel?
I just like being able to see them whenever we just give them the food or the drinks or anything.
Why do you like to see that?
Because it just, when they're happy, it just makes me feel like I've been, like,
fantastic.
Doing
fantastic. And tell us your name.
Gavin.
Gavin. And how do you like helping them?
It just feels like the right thing to do. Like, they don't have a home. I think they deserve something.
So we want to try to help them, right? And how about you? How does it make you feel?
It makes me feel glad to help people that don't have enough money to do things for themselves.
Well, whether it's here in Springfield or even the teams that we send out on a special missions we send out every day through the New Life Evangelistic Center all over the greater St. Louis area, out among the homeless, we welcome volunteers. And if you'd like to volunteer, call us at 314-421-3020 and ask to speak to Pastor Ray Redlick, who's on our team out among the homeless on a daily basis. That's 314-421-3020. Or you can talk to Joe Batson here in Springfield, Missouri, if you want to help. Because when people are hurting, New Life Evangelistic Center is there, reaching out through the love of Jesus Christ. And thanks a lot, guys. I know they got some more people they need to feed over there. God bless you all.
Johnny Robinson, Springfield, Missouri. I'm at the Veterans Coming Home Center on North Jefferson. My disability doesn't last the entire month, and without the Veterans Coming Home Center, I'd probably starve. It just, you know, it makes a difference. I've been trying to save up money to have my teeth fixed, but it's almost impossible to save up money to do something like that on your street. I want to thank you guys for the food. You really appreciate it, and a place to lay down occasionally. Thanks a lot.
My name is Chris Ducker. I've been on the streets since 12 years. Being on the streets in Springfield, kind of in one way. Veterans Coming Home Center is a good place. They could use some more donations. Other than that, if there's people need to know where a good place to go, they can just come to the VA or any other homeless shelter.
806 North Jefferson, a New Life Evangelistic Center, reaching out to hundreds and hundreds of homeless people every week in such a variety of ways, in addition to providing with the laundry and the free store and the storage of belongings, even a place to take a nap and computers to find. When we have bicycles, we even get them in the hands of the homeless, and you got one recently, is that
yes,
right?
Yes, I did. It's a pretty good bike, too.
Tell us your name.
My name is Tommy Yarberry.
And how is that bike helping you, Tommy?
It helps me get back and forth to here. It helps me look for work. Helps me get my exercise.
For is it really? So it's been helping you actually get out, find work, and
and
it's help you in a big way.
Yeah, it helps me in a real big way. And get plenty, you know, get exercise, which I need, you know.
So if people bring more bikes to 806 North Jefferson and Springfield, we can give more away, because I'm sure there's a lot of other homeless people need them in there.
Yeah, I've had a few people ask me where I got it and everything, and I've told them, so I imagine they'll be beating down his door now.
Well, 806 North Jefferson, again, in Springfield, Missouri. Hundreds of homeless people every week come into this place, the largest walk-in shelter, southwestern Missouri, northwestern Arkansas, right here in Springfield. And it's sponsored by the New Life Evangelistic Center and the gifts of those of you that are sharing with New Life Evangelistic Center. Just one of many programs that New Life Evangelistic Center is engaged in, helping the hurting, helping the homeless. That's why you need to give online at newlifeevangelisticcenter.org. Our senior gift, P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri, the 63166. A bicycle. And drop them off at 806 North Jefferson in Springfield. And again, you got one, and it really helped you.
Oh, yeah. It helped me immensely. Yeah. Now I have hope to find work.
Hello, my name is Pastor Chris Rice, and with me is Julie. And Julie, tell us how the ministry here in Springfield at Veterans Coming Home Center has been a benefit to you.
I've made friends. I actually don't fear homeless people anymore. I used to be afraid of them a little bit. Mm-hmm. I didn't know what they were going to do, and I thought they were all insane, pretty much scary. But now I have lots of friends here. Some of them really are scary, but
pretty much. You have meals here, right?
I do. Okay. Yes.
You can shower here and bathrooms.
Yes, and we get clothes and bus passes, so we don't have to pay for the bus, and that way we get to go to doctor's appointments and job interviews and stuff like that. So it's pretty handy. Blankets, so we don't freeze to death in the winter, and all that. Yes. Very nice.
So it's been an important part of your life here lately.
Well, yeah, lately. Yes, very much. It was a cold winter.
Would you encourage people to give to the work of New Life Evangelistic Center?
Absolutely. Sure, why not? Yes.
Well, thank you, Julie. I appreciate it.
No problem.
All right.
Hi, my name is Marie. I'm here at the Veterans today and enjoying the hospitality of a lifetime. This is a wonderful center. Everyone's been so free to me with their feelings and their food and the blessings. I wish I could tell everyone about this place. If I was going to have any talent at all, it would be in hospitality. So since I've received that here, I don't know what I can do to help, but I'll help any way I can. To thank for a warm, dry place to come in out of the rain, hear Christian music, and shake hands with men that signed up and served our country. It's a wonderful place.
New Life Evangelistic Center has outreaches all over Mid-America, particularly out the state of Missouri, including Van Buren, Missouri, and that's where you're from, is that correct?
I am, Van Buren.
Tell us your name.
My name's John Sanders from Van Buren.
And so you work together with Ralph. You referred to him as the Colonel, Ralph Case there.
And Ralph Case.
And our free store that we have and our outreach center in Van Buren. You're
that's
well aware
correct.
Of that.
He referred me up here to, there was help for me to get started with a job and food and shelter. And because of Ralph Case and his help and his organization, I got myself a good start.
Tell everyone your name again.
John.
Yeah, John.
John Sanders.
John Sanders, okay. And this is an example of how the different New Life centers in different locations work together, because here he is in Van Buren, couldn't find a job there.
No jobs in Van Buren, the economy terrible. Many jobs in Springfield, and because of the New Life, mm-hmm. and I got myself a good start, a good job, opportunity, a place to stay, clothes, shirt, shoes, and
so this place at 806 North Jefferson's been a big help to you.
It has, and I found out I can wash my clothes, and I got a place to find clothes, wash my clothes, and shower after work. What a great, great help this has been.
And that's what we want to, and that's why we're fighting so hard. We've encountered a lot of wickedness in the city of St. Louis. Very, very wicked, wicked people that actually persuaded the judge not to give us a stay in our whole case. And they, April the 2nd, we passed all our plumbing codes and everything, but they still closed down the place, took the homeless that were there and stuck them in a warehouse without any indoor plumbing, no place for them to shower, the men, and then the women, they put them in a recreation center. And, you know, we're continuing through the whole court process, but we're working against some real wicked people in the city of St. Louis. They came over the next day, and even though we had, you know, everything we needed to have a boarding house at 5811 Michigan, they condemned the place because they lost their paperwork, that we had all the signatures we turned in, everything we needed for there. So we're fighting that there, but we're continuing to reach out among the homeless, and in this case, 806 North Jefferson and Springfield, homeless people are getting help, and you're a testimony of it.
Well, yes, of course. A person needing a job, wanting a job, and, well, of course, with the help of this facilities and other facilities here in Springfield, this has been a help to get a good start with a great paying job. And sometimes, you know, people just need to, sometimes a person just needs
a hand up, not always
needs
just a hand up.
Not a handout, but just all I needed was
a hand up.
A hand up. And thanks to everything and the people and the facilities, that's just that little push, Larry, that I needed to get this started. And I'm really thankful and I praise God for all the wonderful this facility and its people. In your ministries.
Well, we thank God for those of you that make all this possible. We receive no city, state, or federal dollars, no United Way dollars. It's caring people like you that are sharing your much-needed gifts with New Life Evangelistic Center, P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri, 63166. Or you can give in online at newlifeevangelisticcenter.org. What a blessing you are in the lives of so many hurting, so many homeless people. And I want to say thank God for each one of you that are getting involved at this hour.